Did you understand the class? In the previous class, we have finished learning the fifth lesson, a different kind of school, isn't it? Did you understand that class, children? Today, we want to learn a new poem. That is, Where Do All the Teachers Go? And this poem is written by Peter Dixon. So, who is the author of this poem, children? Peter Dixon. Go. So this poem is written by Peter Dixon. Okay. Our teacher is very special, isn't it? They think that the teacher is very special person, and the child wonders where do the teachers go after the school hours. So children, let us see what the teachers are doing after their school hours. Okay, all of you check your English textbook and open page number 67. Where do all the teachers go when it is 4 o'clock? Do they live in houses and do they wash their socks? Do they wear pajamas and do they watch TV? And do they pick their noses the same as you and me? Do they live with other people? Have they mums and dads? And were they ever children? And were they ever bad? Did they ever never spell right? Did they ever make mistakes? Were they punished in the corner if they pinched the chocolate flakes? Did they ever lose their hymn books? Did they ever leave their greens? Did they scribble on the desktops? Did they wear old dirty jeans? I will follow them back home today. I will find out what they do. Then I will put it in a poem that they can read to you. So children, did you understand anything from these lines? Okay, I'll explain to you. Listen. Where do all the teachers go when it is 4 o'clock? Do they live in houses and do they wash their socks? So here, in this poem, the poet says that the child wants to know where do all the teachers go after 4 o'clock. And he also having the questions, do they live in houses and do they wash their socks? Do they live in houses and do they wash their socks? He wants to know that where his teachers are living in a home and they will wash their socks. Socks means clothes. Okay. Do the teachers, they will wash their clothes. Okay. Socks means clothes. Socks means clothes. Did you understand the first stanza? Then second stanza. Do they wear pajamas? And do they watch TV? And do they pick their noses the same as you and me. Then the child is asking whether his teachers they were wearing pyjamas and whether they like to watch TV or whether they watch the TV and whether they pick their nose means clean your nose by using the little fingers. That means putting the fingers inside the nose and cleaning it. Okay. The same as you and me. That means the child is wondering whether the teachers they are using their little fingers to clean their nose like him. Okay. Whether the teachers they're living with other people, whether they have mothers and dads, and whether they ever children, and where they ever back. And he's asking, but once whether the teachers were children long before, and where they ever back. Where back means not be. Okay. So here, the child having doubts whether his teachers were small children before and where they were naughty or not. Did they ever never spell right? Did they ever make mistakes? Were they punished in the corner if they pinched the chocolate flakes? Now he wonders that whether his teachers, when they were very small, whether they spell the spellings of the words correctly, and whether they made mistakes in giving the correct spelling of the words. Were they punished in the corner if they pinched the chocolate flakes? And he is wondering. His teachers, when they were very small, whether they were punished, they were made to stand in the corner for pinching the chocolate flakes. That means sometimes the children, they used to eat the chocolate when the teacher is taking the classes. Did you ever do that, children? Did you ever do that, say? Here, he is asking whether the teachers, that means when they were very young, very small, at that time their teachers punished them for eating chocolates in the class. Did they ever lose their hymn books? Did they ever leave their dreams? Did they scribble on the desktops? Did they wear old dirty jeans? Now, the child is wondering, did they ever lose their hymn books? Hymn books means the prayer books, okay? That means a collection of devotional songs. Did they ever leave their dreams? Did they throw their vegetables while eating? That means some of the children don't like to eat the vegetables. Do you like to eat the vegetables? Huh? I have seen long before when I was a class teacher, I saw that during lunch time, I saw that many children they keep the vegetables aside. They eat fish and meat and egg and all, but they are not touching the vegetables because. As example, like bitter gourd, they're not eating, but they say it's too much bitter for them. But it is full with vitamins that they don't know. Even though we are saying they are not eating, because and the parents are saying that the child is not eating vegetables. Exactly here, the child is wondering whether his teachers were small children. Do they ever keep their vegetables aside? Greens means cooked आएगा और कुकुम्बर आएगा. ओके Did they wear old dirty jeans? Here in this line, did they scribble on the dust tops? Sometimes, if you are sitting in the class and you see the desk is very clean and tidy, what you will do? You will take the pencil or pen and you will scribble on the desk, isn't it? So here, the child is wondering whether his teachers, when they were very small, they used to scribble the dust tops or not. Did they wear old dirty jeans? Many of you likes to wear the jeans, isn't it? And it is very difficult to wash, isn't it? Well, even we are soaking the thing means when we lift it up, it becomes so heavier, isn't it? So here, the child is asking, did they wear old dirty jeans? That means if you are wearing the jeans means at least nearly for 2 weeks you will not wash the jeans. Isn't it? So here, and he is wondering whether his teachers they used to wear dirty jeans. I'll follow them back home today. I'll find out what they do. Then I will put it in a poem that they can read to you. Then the child says that definitely he will follow one of his teachers and he will find out what they are doing after reaching their home, and he will make it in a poem. He will write a poem about what his teachers are doing after the school hours that they can read to you. Then the teachers they can read it for you. Did you understand, children? So children, this is a very nice poem written by Peter Dixon, and I hope you have understood the poem well. And it is time to wind up the class. If you have any doubts, please ask me.